Hey, detecting motion can be tricky if you have multiple motion sensors in the same room or if motion sensors have a certain dependency on each other. In this Home Assistant tutorial, I explain how you can best set up motion sensors and make automations based on the number of use cases so that they work perfectly for every use case. Motion sensors are generally the first devices you purchase after purchasing your lighting. Most people start by controlling their lighting with motion sensors in Home Assistant. But you can use motion sensors for many more things. How about triggering your alarm system, for example, or sending a message to your phone or your smart speaker when a letter is put in your mailbox? If one motion sensor controls your lighting in a certain room, that's fairly easy to set up. However, if several motion sensors have to work together to control the lighting in one or more rooms, it is sometimes difficult to get them to work together in the right way. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to set up motion sensors in Home Assistant in a few everyday use cases. Use case number one, setting up one motion sensor in Home Assistant. This is quite a simple use case to start with. One lamp is controlled by one motion sensor in one room. If movement is detected, the lamp should turn on. If no movement is detected for 5 minutes, the lamp should go out again. The second use case is about setting up two motion sensors with two lights in Home Assistant. The second use case is a little bit more complex. We have a hall with one lamp inside and one lamp outside. There's a motion sensor in the hall and one at the outside door. When I arrive at the house, the outside light and the light in the hall are switched on based on motion detected outside. When I go in, the light in the hall stays on as long as I stay in the hall, but the outside light goes out after 5 minutes of inactivity. When I leave the hall to enter the rest of my house, the light in the hall goes out. When I enter the hall from my house, only the light in the hall comes on. The outside lighting remains off. When I then walk outside, the outside lights also come on and the hall light goes out after 5 minutes. When I left the house for a while, the outside lights go out after 5 minutes of inactivity. Use case 3 is a challenge. We are going to set up 3 motion sensors with 3 lights in Home Assistant. So we have 3 rooms. Room 1 is a staircase that leads to the basement. Room 2 is the boiler room to which the staircase leads. And room 3 is the garage behind the boiler room. So I walk down the stairs, enter the boiler room and then enter the garage. There's a lamp and a motion sensor in each room. When you walk down the stairs, the light at the stairs and the boiler room will come on. When you get to the boiler room, the light at the stairs, the garage and the boiler room will turn on. When you enter the garage, the lights in the garage and boiler room will turn on. And when I'm in the garage for a while, only the light in the garage stays on and the light in the boiler room and the light in the staircase goes out. When I've left all the rooms, all the lights go out. Now let's head over to the automations. Let's start with the simplest use case. The automation looks like this. This one has a name and the mode is single. Next, we create 2 triggers. I'm using trigger IDs here. If you don't know what those are, check out my trigger IDs video first. You will find the link in the description below. The first trigger is a device trigger, which I gave the trigger ID motion detected. You can set the trigger ID under the 3 dots at the top right of the trigger box. The device is called Motion Detector Room 1 and the trigger is called Motion Detector Room 1 Occupancy Started Detecting Motion. Let's leave the duration at 0. Then the second trigger. It doesn't need a trigger ID. The trigger type is again device. The device is called Motion Detector Room 1 and the trigger is called Motion Detector Room 1 Occupancy Stop Detecting Motion. Here we set the duration to 5 minutes. After all, We only want the light to go out if no movement has been detected for 5 minutes. Then we go to the actions. We start with an if-then action type. At the if, we create a condition and check for the trigger ID by choosing the condition type triggered by and choosing the trigger ID motion detected. Then we set at then which lamp should turn on. We create an action with action type device. The device is Lightroom 1 and the action is turn on Lightroom 1. Now we set when the lamp should go out. We do this by creating an action under else of the type device. The device here is also Lightroom 1 and the action is turn off Lightroom 1. So use case 1 is now working. Let's head over to use case 2. By the way, if my videos help you and if you want to keep up to date with my tutorials and not miss anything to increase your knowledge of Home Assistant and Smart Home, subscribe to my channel and tick the bell. It also helps if you post a comment. This way, more people get notified about my videos. Oh, and don't forget to hit the thumbs up for this video. This allows me to make more tutorials for you. Thank you. Use case 2 is about two rooms with one motion sensor and one lamp for each room. This automation has a name again and the mode is single. We will first define the triggers for our motion sensors in Home Assistant. We start with a device trigger with trigger ID motion detected outside. The device is motion detector hall outside and the trigger is motion detector hall outside occupancy started detecting motion. Let's leave the duration at zero. We do the same for the interior lighting. This device trigger gets trigger ID motion detected inside. The device is called motion detector hall inside and the trigger is called motion detector hall inside occupancy started detecting motion. We also leave the duration at zero here. Now we define the triggers that detect the stopping of motion. The next device trigger has trigger ID motion stopped outside. The device is motion detector hall outside and the trigger is motion detector hall outside occupancy stopped detecting motion. We set the duration to 5 minutes because we want the light to go out only after there has been no movement for 5 minutes. We also do the same for the interior lighting. The device trigger has trigger ID motion stopped inside. The name of the trigger is motion detector hall inside. The trigger is motion detector hall inside occupancy stopped detecting motion. And here we also set the duration to 5 minutes. Then we go to the actions. We first define a choose action with a number of options within it. The first option ensures that the light goes on outside when movement is detected outside. The condition is a triggered by condition that checks for the motion detected outside trigger ID. The actions that go with this turn on the light outside and inside. The first action is of type devices and the device is light hall outside. The action performed is turn on light hall outside. The second action is also of type device and the device is light hall inside. The action being performed is turn on light hall inside. The second option ensures that the light outside turns off after 5 minutes. The condition type is triggered by and the trigger is motion stopped outside. The action is of type device and the device is light hall outside. The action performed is turn off light hall outside. The third option turns on the indoor light when motion is detected indoors. The condition is a triggered by condition that checks for the motion detected inside trigger ID. The associated action turns on the light inside. This action is of type device and the device is light hall inside. The action being performed is turn on light hall inside. The fourth option ensures that the light inside goes out after 5 minutes. The condition type is triggered by and the trigger is motion stopped inside. The action is of type device and the device is light hall inside. The action being performed is turn off light hall inside. Now the second use case also works. Let's head over to use case 3. Use case 3 is about three rooms with one motion sensor and one lamp for each room. Let's open this automation. This automation will ensure that the light follows us when we walk through three rooms, but in some cases also illuminates the next room already. This automation again has a name and has mode single. We will first define the triggers for the motion sensors in Home Assistant. For each motion sensor, we define a trigger to detect motion and to stop detecting motion. We start with the motion detector of the staircase. As you can see here, I defined a trigger ID called Motion Detected Staircase. If you don't know what trigger IDs are, check out my video about trigger IDs first. The link can be found in the description below. Then we select the device. In this case, it is the motion detector staircase. The trigger we want to check for is motion detector staircase occupancy started detecting motion. In my case, this trigger is called that because I use an Akara motion sensor in combination with Zigbee to MQTT. If you use a different motion sensor or, for example, ZHA or DCONS, the trigger can have a different name, but you have to choose the trigger that detects movement. Let me know in the comments which one you use, ZHA, DCONS or Zigbee to MQTT, and what you like best. Let's leave the duration at zero. Now we are going to create the same trigger for the boiler room and the garage. So the boiler room gets the trigger ID Motion Detector Boiler Room. I choose the device Motion Detector Boiler Room, and I choose the trigger Motion Detector Boiler Room Occupancy Started Detecting Motion. Let's leave the duration at zero again. And the garage gets the trigger ID Motion Detected Garage. I choose the device Motion Detector Garage, and I choose the trigger Motion Detector Garage Occupancy Started Detecting Motion. Let's leave the duration at zero again here. Next, we need to create triggers for detecting that there is no more movement in the rooms. Here we do the same for all three motion sensors. We start with the staircase. The staircase gets the trigger ID Motion Stopped Staircase. I choose the device Motion Detector Staircase and choose the trigger Motion Detector Staircase Occupancy Stop Detecting Motion. This time we set the duration to 5 minutes, so the trigger will go off as soon as there has been no movement in the staircase for 5 minutes. We do the same for the boiler room and the garage. The boiler room is given the Motion Stop Boiler Room trigger ID. I choose the device Motion Detector Boiler Room and choose the trigger Motion Detector Boiler Room Occupancy Stop Detecting Motion, and we also set the duration at 5 minutes here. The garage gets the Motion Stopped Garage trigger ID. I choose the device Motion Detector Garage and choose the trigger Motion Detector Garage Room Occupancy Stop Detecting Motion. And here again, we set the duration to 5 minutes. Now let's go to the actions. I start by defining a choose action. Within that, we have a couple of options that correspond to the triggers we defined above. The first condition is of type triggered by, which references the motion detected staircase trigger ID. If movement is detected in the staircase, we want the light to turn on in the staircase and also in the boiler room. So the actions are then as follows. The first action is a device action that refers to the lamp in the staircase. The name of this lamp is Light Staircase. The action to be executed is Turn on Light Staircase. However, we also want the light in the boiler room to turn on, so we define another device action that references the device Light Boiler Room. The action to be performed is Turn on Light Boiler Room. The second condition is of type triggered by, which references the motion detected boiler room trigger ID. If the motion is detected in the boiler room, we want the light to turn on in the staircase and in the boiler room and in the garage. So the actions are then as follows. The first action is a device action that refers to the lamp in the staircase. The name of this lamp is Light Staircase. The action to be executed is Turn on Light Staircase. However, we also want the light in the boiler room to turn on, so we define another device action that refers to the device Light Boiler Room. The action to be performed is Turn on Light Boiler Room. And we also want the light in the garage to turn on, so we define another device action that references the Light Garage device. The action to be performed is Turn on Light Garage. To make sure the light stays on as long as we're in the garage, we are going to add a third option, The third option is of the type triggered by, which references the motion detected garage trigger ID. When motion is detected in the garage, we want the light in the garage to turn on or stay on. So the action is a device action that refers to the lamp in the garage. The name of this lamp is light garage. The action to be performed is turn on light garage. Now we are going to make the actions that will turn off the light. They are actually very simple. If there has been no movement within 5 minutes in a certain room, the light in that room may go out. To do this, we make one option for each room to switch off the light. We start with the staircase. In option 4, we have a condition type triggered by, and the trigger is called motion stopped staircase. The action is again a device action, and the device is called light staircase. The action is turn off light staircase. We do the same for the boiler room and the garage in option 5 and option 6. Option 5 turns off the light in the boiler room based on the condition motion stop boiler room, and option 6 turns off the light in the garage on basis of the condition motion stopped garage. And with that, the automation is complete. The light now follows you nicely as you walk from the stairway to the garage or from the garage to the stairway. If you walk back and the light in the boiler room and stairway is already off, the light in the boiler room and stairway will turn on again as soon as the motion sensor in the boiler room detects your presence. So you have to pay close attention to where you place your motion sensor in the boiler room so that it sees you in time. I hope this video gave you some ideas on how to use motion sensors in Home Assistant. Let me know in the comments if it works for you. Your support allows me to make new videos all the time. You can support me by becoming my patron, buying me a cup of coffee, or joining this channel. The links for this can be found in the description of this video. Please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and check the notification bell. I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye bye!